y'all. Welcome back to Dani's World. I got my sisters and my cousins here, and we are celebrating my mom's 50th birthday.
Larry cried already since I've been here. But at any time, is there anyone who would like to come up and just say a couple of few words? I know we got Pastor Jack here, we got Pastor Diane here. I was calling you up, Pastor Diane, Pastor Jack, Pastor Jack, Pastor Diane. Okay, so we're gonna let Siobhan get started.
And get ready for the tears.
And I don't even know where to start, honestly. I'm grateful isn't even the word to describe how blessed I am to have my mother. I'm just so thankful for her life. I'm so thankful that I'm in her life, and just so that everything that she's done for me and Levon and Danielle. Oh my gosh, I'm trying not to cry. I just love you, Mom, and I'm so thankful that we get to celebrate you today. And I'm just so happy, and I'm so thankful for all of the things that you've accomplished, not only as my mother, but as a woman in general. And I'm just so thankful for your heart and your willingness and your power and your strength, and I love you so much.
Amen. I know I speak for me and Pastor Powell when we say that we are truly, truly excited about what's happening in your life right now. And we are so proud of you. We said that actually in the car too, but we are so proud of you. And you have always, as she said, been that awesome mother. It's like you have always put them first, and you've done so much investing in them. And I see you doing the same thing with your church. And I'm just so proud to be connected to you, to be associated with you. And I just want to say, well done. Well done.
So we're going to have Pastor Diane come up. And then I'm going to ask Elva and someone else. I only know Elva. That's right, Elva. I see your face. To come up and say a couple of words. And someone else, maybe a trustee from the church or elder at the church.
I was trying to decide how long it's been that I've known Levon and Siobhan and Levon since they came to Carmel Christian Church. 7 years, yes, because we all got there about the same time. They got there a little before I did as the interim minister at Carmel. And this is what I learned, that Levon Carson did not want to come to Carmel Christian Church. So they had another interim before I got there, and he didn't like Carmel, and they didn't like him, and so he left, and I came, and Levon was there, and we hit it off. And one of the proudest parts of my life, now I'm going to cry, is that Levon calls me Mama. And I'm very proud of that. And I'm very proud of you, Levon, and what you accomplished and who you are. And so we're glad to be here.
Elva says she's going to get me, y'all. So if anything happens to me, y'all know Elva got me.
Thank you for being there for me, for giving me words of wisdom, for just helping me, and for loving me, loving my kids, my grandkids, and just supporting me. God bless.
I just want to thank you. I've only been a part of your church for a couple years, but in that time you've helped me. A lot of people don't know things that we've gone through with my marriage and my home and my kids, but you've been there with me, and you prayed with me and encouraged me, always checking on me, and I just want you to know you've made a big difference in my life. So I thank you. I'm grateful to God that you're part of my life.
Oh yeah. You getting pictures or video?
I'm Ruben. Oh, go ahead.
I'm Ruben Roque, the moderator of Hope Christian Church, and our great pastor, Pastor Levon, has stuck with us for 5 years. I tell you, if it would have been me, I'd have been gone. But we're a bunch of old fogies, and she has brought such new life to us. She has reinvigorated us, reestablished our mission and our vision, and it's all her doing. And I just praise God for her life. She's exactly what that community needed. And, you know, I don't know if, I'm not getting into politics, but it was just said 700,000 people are going to lose their food stamps across the nation. Well, guess what? There's hope. It's called Hope Connection. And that's her brainchild. Yeah. Hope Connection is bringing food to the community. Yeah. Pastor, we are riding the way, the river of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And I thank God that you are taking us along with it, with you. Hope Christian Church, are we with Pastor Levon?
And I'm going to ask little Christine to come up also. Come on, Ayana.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
I'm representing the nieces and nephews. I'm the favorite niece. I have a special connection with all of my aunties. They're all great, so many of them. But I definitely have a special connection with my Aunt Levon. And I'm a crybaby, so I'm definitely going to cry. But lots of amazing summers and amazing talks with my aunt. A lot of cheerleading camp. mostly a lot of church and a lot of advice, and it was always God-filled and God-driven, and I'm just really happy for you. I'm proud of you. I'd do anything for you, and so that is why I'm here today. I love you, and happy birthday.
I don't know, honestly, where do I start? Because when I met Miss Carson, I met her at a time in my life where, unfortunately, there were some circumstances that I was going through, and she opened up her doors to me, and I was a teenager at this time. And she made my life normal, like so normal as possible, that when I look back, I really don't, like, can't recall how good I had it. Because of how much of an influence that she did for me. There was never a time where I went without anything. There was never a time where I felt like I didn't have anything. And she literally opened up her, I was over her house, I promise you, every single weekend. I was over her house. I practically lived there, literally on the weekends. And there was not one time where I ever felt that the door was closed. And to that, I'm like extremely grateful because of her. Like I said, I had it really good due to the circumstances that I was in. You wouldn't even be able to tell. If there was anything I needed from even my hair being done, I knew she was there. She always included me in everything. I always went with her everywhere, and she's literally like my mom, like my second mom. And so to this day, I'm forever grateful. Because of you, I literally got through, and I was 4 years, because I didn't get out until my prom. So because of you, that was my escape. You know, that was where I could come for anything. And for that, I am extremely grateful for that. Extremely.
Okay, I don't do public speaking, but
teacher.
Mom, I just want to say thank you for being you, because without you, I would not be the woman that I am today. Even what I've been through, even when I don't want to do something, when I'm having hard times, you're still my person, even though I can't lay in the bed with you when I come in late at night anymore because we don't live in the same city, but you are still my person. And every time I call, every time I need you, you're always there. And for that, I'm forever grateful. And I just want you to know that I love you so much. And you know I'll do anything for you, whether it is driving all the way up here in the middle of winter or whenever, you already know that you are my person. So I love you and I got you.
I have a personal few words, I guess that I can do better right now. My mom is 2,500 miles away, and just right at the moment that I miss her the most, past her alone, it looks like she feels that she gets close to me to comfort me a little bit and try to fill that gap that only a mom can fill. Not only that, she's there to support us, the whole family. She's there to be the grandmother that my kids do not have right now. And to be my mom and Jessica's mom, that sounds a little bit weird, but she is like the mother of both of us. And so I just wanted to express it publicly, out loud, at this time, so all of you can hear that and all that, but that is what I really feel for her right now. So I see her like a second mom, and that's it. Yeah, hello. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
My name is Wilfredo. I'm standing here with my wife, Nancy. And this is a celebration faster than it was half a century in the making. So I feel like it's good. I'm standing in the back thinking about what is it that I'm going to say. What is it that they don't know about Carson that I could say? Then again, I say, well, I'm just going to speak of my own experience with Pastor Carson Levine, Pastor Levine. She has been someone that impacted my life in many ways. She has been someone that make a believer out of me. She has been someone that has given me opportunity. And I want to say it has picked me up in many ways and made me a believer. I'm here to celebrate life. I'm here to celebrate your life. I'm here to tell you that we, Nancy and I, the Jesus family, love you. And we want to thank you. We want to thank you for who you are. We want to thank you for the many things that you have done in our life, and you continue to impact the congregation in a very positive way. Finally, we have a leader that we don't mind following. We have a leader that is a godly woman, and I mean, there's so many things that I could say about you, Pastor. Other than that, I love you, I'm proud of you, and I'm really, it's been an honor to get to know you and follow your lead.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Amanda.
Hey, Amanda.
And my words to Pastor LeBun, she's always been very personable. You have a pastor, but she's been more than a pastor from day one that I've met her. You don't have many pastors. I heard someone say that, you know, she does their hair or used to do their hair. She's always been very inviting to me and my girls and my son. So she goes beyond the pulpit and she get personal with you. Her motto is, if I have food, you have food too. If I have a home, you have a home too. And so I am grateful that you are more than just a pastor to me and my children. You are real. And I thank you for that. You're fabulous at 50.
Yes.
Hi, everybody.
Hey, baby.
You already know that. Anyway, mom, first of all, I want to say that you're the best mom ever. And happy birthday, 50, as I should say. But through the years, I've learned a lot from you. You have taught me a lot, taught me how to grow as a person. You've taught me how to work hard in school. You know, I'm going to leave you soon, so you don't know what you're going to do. But I just want to say thank you. Thank you for everything that you have done for us and the Carson family. Thank you for being strong, talented, and helpful, for getting us through the journeys of life.
Yes. Go ahead, baby.
Come on, LaVon. Come on, you got to come with that message.
Hey everyone.
Hi.
So first off, we want to say that, I'm Janelle.
I'm Jenny.
Hi. First off, we want to start with saying we love you, like, so much. You've literally watched us grow from since we were kids to this day, now that we're juniors in college. And it sucks that you're not around the corner like you used to be, but we know that you are only one call away, and we want to say thank you for the teachings and the motivation and understanding everything that we went through, knowing we went through a lot.
Period.
And we are very grateful.
Okay, so when we first got to Augusta, years ago, I was looking like, wow, these people staring at me. Who are these people? But it wasn't like that when I got to Augusta, because as soon as service was done, Pastor LaVon came up to us and was like, this time is Bible study. Y'all need to be here. And so we were there. We created a bond. And so, yeah, and I'm thankful for you. Thank you for doing my hair. So, yeah, love you.
Hi. I had the honor of being the administrator at Carmel Christian Church when she fought her way out to us. And I'm still not sure what the story is behind what she thought we were going to do to her, but it's okay. And I too, as Di said, I'm proud to have her call me mom.
Yes.
I'm sorry. But, I tried to kind of play in between her and the guy who was there before Diane. And she came to us with these two little kids and this really rebellious teenager. Oh my, yes, it was that way. And I remember her fighting her way through all that. And I think she deserves a standing ovation for these wonderful girls.
Okay, so I'm going to be the last one. Then we're going to have some cake and we're going to dance. She is number 8 of 11, and all our names begin with an L. 3 of our siblings have gone on to be with Sweet Jesus, and so have our parents. But we try to make sure that we're together every year, every major celebration, every success, I won't say failure, but every challenge. And for those of you that know her, you know that she's a cancer survivor. So she is our survivor in our family. She's had to battle many things being out here on the other side of the world, doing her own thing, because most of us are on the East Coast. So she's always been in this really, 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 really cold weather. About 5 years ago today, she became the pastor of Hope Christian Center. And we were here celebrating with you all when she got installed at Carmel. We came and celebrated with you. So that's just what kind of family we are. And I'm gonna ask her sisters and brother-in-laws to stand up.
That's them.
And we are missing one of our sisters who's alive and one of our brothers who couldn't come. But we love her. We celebrate her. Now, if you want to hear the real story, you need me in the corner. I'm going to tell y'all some stories when she's little. But she has turned out to be a wonderful, wonderful person, sister, sibling, mother, sister, aunt. She will do. And she has that nurturing spirit from our parent. Our mother was a nurturer. It's kind of sort of like a curse and a blessing, because you can take all of these people in, and sometimes you forget to take yourself in. Mm-hmm. So therefore, we have to make sure, and I know that Hope Christian Center is doing this for her. Make sure that you're taking care of her. Somebody needs to check on her while she's checking on everybody else, because as they say, the pastor needs to be pastored. So just continue to love on our sister. We love all of you. We dubbed Lamerna and LaDiane as one of the L sisters, and they know it. And we just want to make sure that continued blessings are bestowed upon each one of you. So at this time, there's cake in the back. Please get some of this delicious cake. Please make sure that you take a picture with Pastor LaVon so she can have it and send it to her. And again, we just want to continue to fellowship and love on her and just celebrate, okay?
Amen.